So I would like to speak to you a little bit about the materia medica. In my first years of studying, and also in the homeopathic colleges, the usual complaint from all students was that the materia medica was a mass of information put together that nobody could make head or tails. That was the usual complaints from all students, and they could never, I mean, the professor was coming there, he was relating symptoms, one after the other, and in the end, nobody would remember anything, or will remember a few things. After all these years of studying and seeing the patients and meditating, I mean, not with the spiritual word, you know, I don't want to be misunderstood. Meditate, I mean by the, I just gave thought to the matter. The idea dawned upon me that, first of all, for every remedy, we have different stages. So, in every stage, there is a kind of symptomatology. If the person progresses to another stage, which is deeper, we have another kind of symptomatology. And if he progresses further, then we have another kind of symptomatology. The confusion was coming from mixing the symptoms of the different stages. Another thought that dawned upon me was that each remedy had a central theme, a central idea that should be grasped by the practitioner and utilized in prescribing. If such an idea would be really grasped for every remedy, then we can have in mind the idea, and around this idea build up the whole of symptomatology. And then we may find that we are able then to remember the symptomatology for each remedy and to remember the essence of symptomatology. I would like to take a few examples to show you what I mean. I should like to talk to you first about platina. Platina. After seeing cases that we needed platina to prescribe, and I can give you an estimation how frequently platina is prescribed, at least in our clinic, I may say, it's an estimation, 1 in 200 or 300. After seeing all these cases, the idea came into my mind that the central theme for platina could be expressed as exaggeration and distortion. So, the only thing that we have to remember about platina are two words, exaggeration and distortion. Another immediately the question comes upon the mind, where is the exaggeration? In what part of man? And where the distortion? It is an exaggeration which refers to the ego of the human being, and usually when we talk about platina, we are talking about a woman. It's more frequently indicated in women. So the exaggeration is on the ego. And that is a lot of exaggeration is interchanged with the sexual energy. So in platina we have exaggeration and distortion with two polarities, ego and sexual energy. This idea now will make it very clear for us to recognize a platina case. In a child, we shall see the exaggeration of ego. What we shall see? The child is too proud of her attainments, of her abilities to be able to do things. When she passes puberty and there is an awakening of the sexual energy, two things can happen in that child. According to the education she has, there will be an awakening of sexual energy which will be great. But the child had this great image of herself already. So within the child already we shall see a pulling force. I mean, I am this and that and I can do anything and all that, and suddenly there is an awakening of sexual energy that demands something which is absolutely mundane. And there is a starting of torment inside the child. From the one point, the ego does not want to give up into mundane affairs like that. And on the other hand, the exaggeration on the sexual energy is such that will drive her to have sex affairs, to have relationships. Such children are usually sensitive. And because of that prominence of their ego, they see things in an idealistic way, usually. But the first relationship which they have is not fulfilling, because the sexual demand is not met by the partner. And there is a frustration. And then there is a second love affair, and then a third love affair, and then a frustration, and a greater frustration. And inside that individual, there is a constant battle between idealism and materialism. Remember now the idea of exaggeration and distortion. A platina case, we're talking about pathology now. A platina case is going to develop some pathology. Where that pathology will go, that is what we are interested. So we shall see eventually that the pathology, we shall center it in two parts. If idealism is stronger than the sex urge, will be suppressed, and all that sexual energy will be transformed into a kind of exaggerated ego. So we see the repertory haughtiness. It becomes very haughty. In the books it says platina is a remedy for nymphomania. When we have nymphomania, when we have an exaggeration and a perversion on the sexual sphere, then we have the mental free from the symptoms of platina. We do not have, in such persons who indulge into sex practices which are much more demanding than usual demands, we do not see the perversion in the mental sphere. So the idea is that a platina believes that what she has is bigger than the others. When it is that expressed in sex, she feels that she gives more than she takes. And she is always frustrated in her relationships. When that goes into the mental sphere, she feels that she is more excellent than anybody else. That in both spheres can be worse and worse until on the sexual sphere, we have perversions, we have sexual perversions, and then in the mental sphere, we have mental perversions. And then we have the symptoms that she feels her head becomes bigger, her parts of body to be exaggerated, the whole body feels big, while the others, they feel far and small. I remember a case which for which she had a lot of fears, fear of the dark, fear of being alone, fear of thunderstorms and all that, and it was prescribed phosphorus. Then nothing happened, and she came back, and she wanted to see me because she had something to say that she could not say to the doctor. They did not have enough contact, or I don't know what has happened. She had not said it, she had omitted. So she came and told me that, she says, I don't know if I'm going crazy. But what happens is that a few days ago, I was in a hill. A few days ago, I was out in the street. And I was looking on the trolley buses, big buses. And I felt as if I was on a hill, and I was looking down on the buses. It's so far. She had been waking in the night, and she had all kind of pervert feelings about the furniture. That the furniture took another image than what it was, and that she was found herself in a strange place. It is one platina is one remedy that is considered to be a very sensual remedy. I have noticed that such individuals, they have thick lips. It is strange, but it's a physical symptom, and lips being an expression of sensuality in a way or another. But the most strange thing is that in this area, it's that they usually have their affections. And in the repertory it says, a numbness around the lips. This is not exactly a numbness, it's a peculiar sensation that sometimes would be described as if I cannot express what I want to say due to mechanical reasons on my tongue or my lips. Or that I may have a brain episode and I shall be paralyzed in my lips. Platina would be indicated, of course, in children which in their puberty they are in the habit of masturbation without knowing what they are doing. Usually, such children, they will go somewhere near a furniture or something hard to press their genitals. And it is a local irritation which brings about the excitement. This is different from oregano, which we see rather as a hormonal dysfunction. Oregano children can be a child of 3 or 4 years old. That she has tremendous sexual urge, which is in a way deeper than platina. So when these exaggerations, they go further into the mental spheres, they pervert so much the mind that platina wants to kill her own child, the child which she loves most from anything else. Before now she goes into such stages, there are stages where she passes, like grief, depression, and some kind of tendency to suicide, but not as strong as the aurum suicidal tendency. These emotional disturbances she will get during the time of the conflict. Once the conflict is settled, either it will go to sexual perversion or it will go to the mental. And then we have an erotic mania when she's mentally sick, or a person who claims to be from a high family. I mean, this exaggeration of ego becomes completely out of proportion. We have a completely insane person who says, I'm coming from a royal family, or I am the prime minister, or ideas of grandeur like that. What we have to see is that idea of exaggeration and perversion, and build our idea of platina on this basis. Also remember that the two poles in platina is the mental, the ego, and the sexual sphere. Cannot get enough. Things that has more than she takes, gives more than she takes. Now the little details now you can find in the repertory. In the repertory you can find all the little details about platina. This is not important. The important is to have spotted the heart of the remedy, to have understood the heart of the remedy. Once you have understood that, you will recognize it in the patient as he talks with you. Now, seeing the essence of remedies in this way, can somebody tell me what would be the essence for arsenicum, alum? Restlessness, security, insecurity. Insecurity. You must have read the paper that Bill sent you. No, I don't want such information. Yeah. I see. Which paper have not sent them? With the, Mercury? Mercury? You have not said. Yeah. That was good, yeah. Okay. Okay, you got me. Okay, you...